You know, Jake, back in Chicago, I never thought I'd be punching cattle, mostly belonging to other guys.
Yeah, using trucks for wrestling's the latest thing. Come on, let's get going before them bloodhounds wake up.
Stealing cattle is a thing right now that's happened out here since we've lived here.
You think that's an Old West deal, but it happens every day across the U.S. right now even. When livestock are worth money, somebody's going to want to take them.
When Tim was running yearlings, cattle went missing from on our place. Sheriff got called and they were never found. My sister-in-law lost, I'm not sure how many, a couple trailer loads, I believe, of sheep. They haven't been found. People are watching, and when they know you're not there, they might come and steal them. So it's really important to have that brand on there, because that's just one other way that the police can try to find your cattle for you. That'd just be like your anything that you own, any other human owns, they'd want it back too. And this is our livelihood. Yeah, it's a real thing that goes on all the time.
Family brand. I purchased that brand from the South Dakota Brand Board close to 20 years ago.
Well, Tim had the brand before he met me, so it's a Lazy 3 Arrow. It's just a one iron brand, which is really handy.
For me, it's nice just because it's less stress on the livestock. It's quicker at branding. I don't like to hurt calves any more than you have to, or the cows. And so the less iron on flesh you can have, the better, in my opinion.
People from town that I've spoken to, even my sister, she thinks it's terribly cruel and mean. I can see where she would think that. It does hurt them. It's not a pleasant thing. I like to think of it sort of like when you have a son and you're at the hospital and he's a day old and he gets circumcised. It's quick. He's never going to remember it, you know? And so that's what I kind of try to think about it for the cattle. Yeah, it hurts, but it's quick. We try to make it as painless as possible, and it serves a very important purpose. It's not just something we do to just hurt the cattle.
As a beef producer, you want your beef to be the best that it can be, and if it's carrying your brand, that cow is always going to be marked for the life as having come from your place. So the brand, as much as the cow itself, represents what you're spending your time doing. Whether it's in the sale barn or makes good beef, the person selling that beef knows where it came from because of the brand. That's what it's all about. All the people here helping us, we will go help them at their branding. I mean, it starts in end April, runs through the first part of May. It's just branding season. It's track season, it's branding season now.
A lot of stress. Well, Tim takes care of all the cattle stuff, setting up the corrals, calling the people. He discusses like the dates with me, and we figure out what date works the best. For me, planning out the meals, getting the vaccine. It's spring, so the yard's kind of a disaster. Clean up the yard. So yeah, it's a good 3 days of work right up to the branding. And then several weeks beforehand, just the planning.
I know the wives are very underappreciated, possibly overlooked, might be a better word for it. They don't see how much a ranch wife does to keep that ranch going, whether it's encouraging or cooking the meal for the branding crew or the preg testing crew or the you name it, there's something going on all the time. And yeah, can't say enough about them.
There are a lot of wives out here that are a cowgirl and a ranch wife. I am a ranch wife, not a cowgirl. I grew up in the cities. I help whenever he needs me. I'm always there. If he's got a prolapse in the middle of the night, I'm out there helping deal with that. Yeah, it's misunderstood that when you meet a ranch wife and you think, oh, all she does is sit at home all day and knit a scarf or something. That's not what's going on.
I feel like I'm pretty lucky because the people we have help us are all kind of in the same boat. They're ranchers. They know what they're doing. They're good, solid help. I can pretty much say, here's the pasture, let's gather it. I might delegate one person to go one way with a group of people and one to go another, but for the most part, everybody can see what needs to be done.
We're all pretty good about doing things the way that whoever's branding you're at wants it done. Everybody does it a little different. You learn what they want and you do it their way. At the end of the day, everybody wants it to go smoothly, no one to be hurt, least trauma on the cattle. people step in, they see what needs to be done, and they do it. Branding season lasts, seems like forever for a while, so you get lots of practice and you get really good by the end of it.
It does get to be a very efficient machine because they can see what's happening, they can see a wreck before it happens. I'm really encouraged with the people that we work with. They're very encouraging to the kids. They're telling them, good job. They're upbeat. They're not just being critical when they do something wrong. They're being positive too, and it's a fun social time. I've said for a while that the kids would work for food and a pop any day of the week, so everybody there has done it enough times that it just goes smooth, even if it's less than ideal conditions.
Ranching is not a job. It is your life. That can be frustrating at times, but it really is your life, and you're really cultivating in these kids a love for this way of life. By teaching them, letting them follow you, help with everything, even if they're just watching or playing a really tiny part of it, you're teaching them to be great stewards of the land, the cattle, to help your neighbor, to love your neighbor. We need somebody to carry that on. I don't think it's something you can just learn from going to school. You need to live it a little bit, so very important.
I don't know as it's so much of passing on a tradition, but just keeping things alive and giving them the opportunities to learn and grow with knowing what used to be, what is, and what might be in the future, and trying to adapt and still have a livelihood to do it with, I guess.
I feel very proud of watching the kids out there, to watch how they help others and how they're excited to go help others at other people's brandings. I know my husband, when we have been gathering before, has leaned over to me and said, oh, I'm just so happy. Look at our herd. I've always dreamed of this. It's his dream come true. And he just feels very proud of it and very blessed that he's had this opportunity. It's really hard to become a rancher without just inheriting or somehow having a really good way in. And God's blessed him and let him do that.